Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome back to the special edition of 11 News, Remembering William Donald Schaefer. I'm Stan Stovall.
I'm Donna Hamilton, joined here today by C. Fraser Smith, Fraser Smith,
saying
it right, who's the senior news analyst for WYPR, and you've been with us the entire service, and just been such a beautiful thing. Mr. Schaefer now, of course, is going to be leaving Baltimore for the very final time. And a procession will take him to Delaney Valley Memorial Gardens, yes, where he will be interred.
Exactly. Mr. Smith has written a wonderful book that we've been talking about, some excerpts, Remembering William Donald Schaefer. Just a wealth of information for those who haven't been around long enough or old enough to remember the early beginnings. It starts at the beginning, takes us right through the through his life's career. More than 50-plus years of public service to the citizens of Baltimore City and the state of Maryland.
When you talked to him, were there things that you found out that surprised you about him? Or did you feel like you know everything?
I've been finding out things the last 10 days. More dimensions. I mean, you feel like you've captured the man, and I did my best. But, you know, I've spoken with so many people whose names we don't know and others who we heard today, and all of them. For example, Rick Burnt, who's an important lawyer in the city, managed the Inner Harbor campaign for William Donald Schaefer.
Right.
Said on WYPR the other day that Schaefer really never had that angry streak in him when they were meeting and planning things. It was all much more studied and focused. You know, one of the things that occurs to me today is that Schaefer's political life really began in an Episcopal church. Bishop Cummins Memorial Church, I believe, near Edgewood Street, where he grew up. Mm-hmm. He, one day, Theodore R. McKeldin, the Republican mayor and governor, spoke in his church, and he was very taken by that. And then there was a situation where the church wanted to buy a piece of land, and somebody else got it away from them. And it really upset him, and he thought, I need to get in a position where I can prevent things like that from happening.